Welcome back to my channel, Miss Medicine. This is the part 3 of Croc 2 2018. So the question is, a 7-year-old boy has been an inpatient for 1.5 months. He had been delivered to the hospital with complaints of edemas all over his body, low urine output and headache. Clinical urinalysis, proteins are 7.1 gram, leukocytes 1-2 in the vision field, erythrocytes 3-4 in the vision field. During the course of the treatment, the edemas gradually dissipated, headache abated, diuresis normalized, daily urine proteins 3 gram per liter, biochemical blood test, total protein 43.2 gram, urea is 5.2 millimole per liter, cholesterol 9.2, but glomerulonephritis syndrome is the most likely to be present in this patient. So the protein is 7.1 gram per liter in urine. So the answer is nephrotic syndrome. If the urine is 3.5 or less than 3.5, then the nephritic syndrome. If it is more than 3.5, then it is nephrotic syndrome. Next question. The mother of a 3-month-old child came to the family doctor with complaints of her child being physically underdeveloped and suffering from cough attacks and dyspnea. Anamnesis, the child is the result of second full-term pregnancy with the risk of miscarriage. The first child died of pulmonary pathology at the age of 4 months, according to the mother. Body mass at birth is 2,500. Cough attacks were observed from the first days of life. Twice the child was treated with bronchitis. Considering the severity of the child's condition, the doctor made the referral for hospitalization. What diagnosis was most likely stated in the referral? The answer is mucoviscoidosis, cystic fibrosis. Next question. A 10-year-old girl complains of stomach ache that appears and intensifies after she eats rough or spicy food, sore irritation, heartburn, frequent constipations, headaches, irritability. She has been presenting with these signs for 12 months. Her meals are irregular and consist of dry food. Objectively, her diet is sufficient in calories. The tongue is moist with white coating near the root. The abdomen is soft and painful in the epigastrium. What method would be optimal for diagnosis making in this case? The answer is esophagogastroduodenoscopy. Next question. A 23-year-old patient had taken 1 gram of aspirin to treat acute respiratory infection. After that, he developed an asthmatic fit with labored expiration that was arrested by introduction of aminophylline. The patient's medical history is not burdened with allergies. The patient has undergone 2 surgeries for nasal polyposis in the past. What diagnosis is most likely? The answer is aspirin-induced asthma. Next question. A 50-year-old patient was delivered to a hospital with complaints of blood traces in the urine. Urination is painless and undisturbed. Macrohematuria had been observed for 3 days. Objectively, kidneys cannot be palpated. Suprapubic area is without alterations. External genitalia are non-pathologic. On rectal investigation, prostate is not enlarged. Painless, has normal structure. Cystoscopy revealed no alterations. What is the most likely diagnosis is renal carcinoma. Next question. A 36-year-old man has been complained of marked weakness, low appetite and nausea for the last year and a half. Within the last year, he has lost 10 kg of the body mass. The skin is dark, especially on his face, neck and arms. Skin folds and nipples are hyperpigmented. There are pigment spots on the patient's inner thigh. Pulse is 60 per minute, BP is 80-50. What is the provisional diagnosis? The answer is adrenal insufficiency because there is darkening on his face, neck and arms and also on inner thighs. Next question. A 5-year-old child that contacts with viral hepatitis in the kindergarten presents with increased body temperature up to 38 degrees Celsius, weakness, low appetite, single case of vomiting, dull pain in the subcostal area. On the right, the child is provisionally diagnosed with viral hepatitis. What examination would be the most informative for diagnosis confirmation, ALT activity in blood? Next question. A patient with trauma of the lower third of the forearm volar surface caused by a glass shard, came to a first aid center. Flexion of the fourth and fifth fingers is impaired. Sensitivity of the inner dorsal and palmar surfaces of the hand and fourth finger is decreased. What nerve is damaged? The answer is ulnar nerve. Next question. A man diagnosed with closed angle glaucoma, grade 2A, of the right eye is registered for regular medical checkups in the evening. An acute glaucoma attack occurred in his right eye. An ambulance was called. What emergency aid would be optimal in this case? Pilocarpine, diacarb, acetazolamide and lytic mixtures are given. Next question. A 58-year-old patient complains of pain in the lower left extremity, which aggravates during walking, and sensation of cold and numbness in the both feet. The patient has been suffering from this condition for 6 years. The skin is pale and dry with hyperkeratosis. On the left shin, hair is scarce. Pulse cannot be detected over the pedal and popliteal arteries and is weak over the femoral artery. On the right limb, pulsation of the popliteal artery is retained. What is the most likely diagnosis? The atherosclerosis obliterans of the lower extremities. Next question. A 22-year-old woman, Gravida 1, Para 0, arrived with complaints of sharply painful contractions that occur every 4-5 minutes and last for 25 to 30 seconds. Amniotic fluid did not burst. The fetus is in transverse lie. Fetal heartbeats are not affected. Contraction ring is acutely painful, located obliquely at the umbilicus. What is the most likely diagnosis? The answer is impending uterine rupture. Next question. During regular checkup, the door examines a young woman, a student with height of 162 cm and weight of 59 kg. She complains that in the evening, she becomes unable to see clearly the objects around her. Objectively, her skin is dry, presents with hyperkeratosis. Her daily ration has the following vitamin content: vitamin A 0.5, vitamin B1 2.0, vitamin B2 2.5, vitamin B6 2 mg, vitamin C 70 mg. Make the diagnosis. Hypervitaminosis A. Next question. An infant is 2.5 months old. The onset of the disease was gradual. The child had normal body temperature but presented with slight cough. Within a week, the cough intensified, especially at night. On the 12th day, the child developed cough fits occurring up to 20 times per day and followed by vomiting. There was one instance of respiratory arrest. Make the diagnosis. The answer is pertussis, whooping cough is present. Next question. A man works in casting of non-ferrous metals and alloys for 12 years. In the year of working area, there was registered high content of heavy metals, carbon monoxide and nitrogen. During periodic health examination, the patient presents with asthenovegetative syndrome, sharp pains in the stomach, constipations, pain in the hepatic area. In urine, aminovalonic acid and coprofyrin are detected. In blood, reticulocytosis, low hemoglobin level is present, and such intoxication is caused by lead and lead salts. Coprofyrin are detected in the urine, are the toxins that seen in lead poisoning. Next question. Due to introduction of a new treatment method, average duration of therapy in the experimental group was 12.3 plus minus 0.2 days compared to 15.4 plus minus 0.4 days in the control group that was treated by the old method. But calculations should be made to estimate the statistical significance of the difference in the results. T-test, students, t-distribution. If in any question that is given 12.3 plus minus 0.2 days or 15.4 plus minus 0.4 days, so the answer will be students to distribution. It's just a cramming question. Next question. Establishments participating in medical examinations include medical and preventive treatments facilities, hygiene and preventive treatment facilities, socio-medical expert committees, Ministry of Defense medical committees, Ministry of Domestic Affairs medical committees, forensic medicine agency, etc. Specify what service deals with socio-medical assessment of temporary disability. The answer is medical and preventive treatment facilities. Next question. A 14-year-old boy presents with moderate bronchial asthma in its exacerbation period. What drug should be prescribed to stop an acute attack of expirative dyspnea? The answer is salbutamol. Next question. A newborn with gestational age of 31 weeks presents with hypotonia and depressed consciousness. Hematocrit is 35%. General CSF analysis shows increased content of erythrocytes and protein and low glucose. This data corresponds with the clinical presentation of intracranial hemorrhage. Next question. A 16-year-old girl has primary amenorrhea, no pubic hair growth, normally developed mammary glands. Her genotype is 46XY. Uterus and vagina are absent. What is your diagnosis? The answer is testicular feminization syndrome. No pubic hair growth, primary amenorrhea, menses are not started. Genotype is 46XY and uterus or vagina are absent. So diagnosis, testicular feminization syndrome. Next question, 6 hours ago, the waters of a 30-year-old Gravida 1, para 0, burst. Her preliminary period was pathologic and lasted for over 2 days. The term of pregnancy is 39 weeks. No labor activity is observed. Fetal head presence above the pelvic inlet. Fetal heartbeats are 142 per minute, clear and rhythmic. On vaginal examination, the uterine cervix is not dilated. What further tactics should the doctor choose? The answer is perform C-section. Next question. Mother of an 8-year-old girl complains that the child is too short and has excessive body weight. Objectively, obesity with fat deposits on the torso and face, round moon face line. Acne striae on the thighs and lower abdomen and hirsutism is present. What hormone can cause such symptoms when in excess? The answer is cortisol. Next question. A 9-year-old girl complains of fever up to 38.5 degrees Celsius. Headache, inertness, weakness, loss of appetite, stomachache and frequent painful urination. Provisional diagnosis of acute pyelonephritis is made. Clinical urine analysis, specific gravity, 1016, no protein, leukocytes, 10 to 15 in the vision field. What investigation method can verify the diagnosis of UTI? The answer is bacteriological inoculation of urine. Common E. coli is the cause of UTI. If E. coli is not present, then Proteus. Second most common is Proteus. Next question. A newborn has Apgar score of 9. When should the infant be put to the breast in the delivery room? Next question. During assessment of work conditions at the factory manufacturing mercury thermometers, the content of mercury vapors in the air of the working area is revealed to exceed the maximum concentration limit. Specify the main pathway of human body exposure to mercury. The answer is respiratory organs are damaged. Next question. In the process of hiring, a prospective employee has undergone preventive medical examination and was declared fit to work in this manufacturing environment. What type of preventive medical examination was it? Preliminary. Next question. A 47-year-old woman came to the admission on room with complaints of general weakness, dizziness, vomiting with blood clots. Condition onset was 3 hours ago. The patient has no preceding illnesses. Blood pressure is 90-60, pulse is 106, of poor volume. The abdomen is soft with mild tenderness in the epigastrium. Blood test erythrocyte 2.1, HB 70, hematocrit 28%. What tactics should the doctor on duty choose? Consult a surgeon. Next question. A 23-year-old woman came to the gynecologist with complaints of blood smears from her genital tracts that have been observed for a long time. Her menstruation has been delayed for 8 weeks. Examination shows the uterine body to be enlarged up to 14 weeks of pregnancy. Ultrasound detected a vesicular mole. What tactics should the doctor choose? Curettage of the uterine cavity. Dilatation and curettage should be done. Next question. A 52-year-old patient complains of pain in the right part of her chest, dyspnea, cough with large amounts of foamy sputum, emitting foul smell and resembling meat slops. Objectively, the patient's condition is grave. Cyanosis is observed. Breathing rate is 31 per minute. Percussion sound above the right lung is shortened. Auscultation revealed various moist rails, crackles. What is the most likely diagnosis? The answer is lung gangrene necrosis. Next question. A man complains of sore throat on the left pain in his left ear. Temperature up to 39 degrees Celsius and nasal sound of his voice. Disease onset was 5 days ago. Marked tremors and increased salivation are observed. The head tilts to the left shoulder. Left side of the soft palate presents with swelling, hyperemia and infiltration. Retromandibular lymph nodes on the left are acutely painful on palpation. Otoscopy results are normal. Make the diagnosis left-sided peritonsillar abscess. Next question. A patient has the second and third degree burns of the 15% of the body surface. On the 28th day after the trauma, the patient presents with sharp increase of body temperature, general weakness, rapid vesicular respiration, facial features are sharpened, BP is 90-50, heart rate 112. What complication is it? The answer is sepsis. And Pseudomonas aeruginosa is the infective agent in burn patients. Next question. A patient in the state of clinical death is being resuscitated through mouth-to-mouth artificial pulmonary ventilation and external cardiac massage. Doctor noticed that air does not flow into the patient's airway and his head and torso are positioned at the same level. But is artificial respiration ineffective in the case? The answer is tongue retraction. Next question. An employee has been sick for 4 months. Further treatment is necessary. The patient is unable to work. Who is authorized to provide further disability examination of this patient? The answer is socio-medical expert committee. Next question. A population of a small town often presents with registered cases of juvenile cardiomyopathy, atherosclerosis, hypertension, endocrinopathy, chronic dermatitis, and arthralgia. Signs of Krishan disease, which is the most likely cause of this pathology? Selenium deficiency in the environment is the cause of Krishan disease. Next question. In 2 hours after a traffic accident, a 28-year-old man in grave condition was delivered to a hospital. The patient complains of abdominal pain. He received a blow to the abdomen with the steering wheel. Objective examination revealed the following. The abdomen does not participate in respiration, is tense and acutely painful on palpation. Abdominal guarding is present. Peritoneal irritation signs are positive. Hepatic dullness is absent. BP 90-60. Heart rate is 120 per minute. What further treatment tactics should be chosen? The answer is laparotomy. Next question. A 48-year-old woman was arrived to the surgical unit with wounds in her thigh. On examination, the wound surface has dirty gray coating with unpleasant sweet smell. Wound content resembles raspberry jelly. Skin tissues around the wound are glossy and turgid. Palpation reveals moderate crepitation in the tissues. What microflora is the most likely to be the cause of such inflammation? The answer is anaerobic clostridia, which is air bubbles are seen. And management will be penicillin or hyperbaric oxygen. Next question. The gynecology unit received a patient with uterine bleeding that started 6 hours after induced abortion at the term of 11th to 12th weeks. Objectively, the skin is pale, pulse is 100, BP is 170. On vaginal examination, the uterus is painless. Its enlargement corresponds to the 10th week of pregnancy. Uterine cervix is dilated enough to let in one finger. There are fragments of the fertilized ovum. What action should be taken next? The answer is urgent repeated curettage of the uterine cavity. Next question. A woman came to the general practitioner with complaints of fatigability, significant weight loss, weakness, and loss of appetite. She has been presenting with amenorrhea for the last 8 months. 1 year ago, she gave birth to a live full-term child. Blood loss during delivery was 2 liters. The woman received blood transfusion and blood components. What is the most likely diagnosis is Sheehan syndrome, which is postpartum hypopituitarism. Sheehan syndrome is also known as Siemens syndrome. Next question. To assess the effectiveness of medical technologies and determine the power and direction of their effect on the public health indicators, the research was conducted to study the immunization rate of children and measles incidence rate by district. What method of the statistical analysis should be applied in this case? The answer is calculation of correlation coefficient. Next question is, a 22-year-old woman complains of itching and profuse discharge from her genital tracts. The condition developed 10 days ago after a sexual contact. Bacteroscopy of a discharge sample detected trichomonas. What drug should be for treatment in this case is metronidazole. Next question, a 30-year-old patient was hospitalized in an intensive care unit with the diagnosis of multiple bee stings. Skin is pale and covered with cold sweat. Pulse can be palpated only at the carotid arteries and is 110 per minute. Breathing rate is 24. Rhythmical, weak. What drug must be administered immediately? The answer is epinephrine hydrochloride. Next question, a 46-year-old woman has been hospitalized with open fracture of the left thigh in its middle third. She underwent the surgery fixation with extrusious osteosynthesis plates. On the fourth day after the surgery, she developed pain in the wound. Body temperature rise over 39 degrees Celsius. What measures should be taken in this case? The answer is undo the sutures, drain the wound and prescribe antibiotics. Next question, women with blood group B Rh positive gave birth to a full-term healthy boy. Examination on the third day of the infant's life shows him to have ectaric tint to his skin. The child has no problems with suckling, sleep is non-disturbed, the abdomen is soft, liver protrudes by 2 cm from under the costal margin, CBC Hb is 200, erythrocytes 5.5, total bilirubin 62, indirect bilirubin 52. What condition can be suspected? Physiological jaundice. If there will be unconjugated bilirubin present, then the answer will be pathological jaundice. Next question, a 45-year-old man developed constricting retrosternal pain that occurs during walking at a distance of 200 meters. Objectively, heart rate is 80 per minute, BP is 160-90. During cardiopulmonary exercise test at 50 watt, there is a depression of ST segment by 3 mm below the isolin in V3, V4. What is the provisional diagnosis? The answer is exertional angina pectoris function class. Because patient can only walk 200 meters and the pain will start, I already discussed about the classification function class 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th in previous videos. You can watch that videos for the classification. Next question, a multigravida on the 38th week of her pregnancy complains of increased BP up to 140-90, edema of the shins for 2 weeks. In the last month, she gained 3.5 kg of weight. Urine analysis, protein 0.033. Make the diagnosis. The answer is preeclampsia. If it is less than 5, then mild preeclampsia. If it is more than 5, protein is severe preeclampsia. Next question, for the last 15 years, a 48-year-old patient has been working at the factory producing synthetic resins. Lately, he has been complaining of significant general fatigue, headaches, frequent urination, predominantly during the day, red color of urine. What complication of benzene nitro compounds poisoning can be suspected? The answer is malignant tumor of the urinary bladder. Next question, a 44-year-old patient with post-infarction on cardiosclerosis presents with frequent heart rate disorders and lower extremity edema. Pulse rate is 95 per minute, irregular 10 to 12 extra systoles per minute, BP 135-90. The first heart sound at the apex is weak. Pulmonary respiration is rough. Liver is enlarged plus 2 cm. ECG irregular sinus rhythm, heart rate 95 per minute, frequent polytopic ventricular extrasystoles. What antiarrhythmic drug is advisable in this case for treatment and prevention of extrasystole? The answer is amiodarone, which is the safest drug. Next question, a 60-year-old woman started feeling weakness, vertigo, rapid fatigability during the last year. Recently, she has developed dyspnea and paresthesia observed. Skin and mucous membrane are pale and ectaric. Lingual papillae are smoothened out. Liver and spleen are at the edge of the costal arc. Blood test, Hb 70, erythrocyte 1.7, very low. blood color index 1.2 and macrocytes present. So the deficiency is vitamin B12 deficiency. Macrocytes are present. Next, after excessive consumption of fatty food in 60-year-old woman, suddenly developed pain in her right subcostal area, nausea, bile vomiting, sharp bitter taste in her mouth. In 2 days, she developed jaundice, her urine darkened, sclera and skin are ectaric, the abdomen is distended, the liver is enlarged by 3 cm, soft and painful or palpation. Ordner's Murphy's, Gehr's and Zakarin's myorobin signs are positive. Where diagnostic technique should be used in the first place to confirm the diagnosis? The answer is the ultrasound of the gallbladder and bile duct. Next question. The subjective of a statistical research was to what extent the population peruses the available medical services. For this purpose, 300 residents of the area were interviewed. Information was collected by means of a special questionnaire. What method of collecting information was used by the researchers? The answer is anamnestic history taking. Next and the last question for this video. A 30-year-old woman complains of increased body weight and problems with physical exertion. Her parents are of increased body weight as well. Typical meals in their family are high in fat and carbohydrates. Blood pressure is 135/80, pulse is 89 per minute, weight is 87 kg, height is 165 cm. The patient's skin is clear with even distribution of subcutaneous fat. The thyroid gland is not enlarged. There are no menstrual cycle disturbances. What obesity prevention methods would be the most advisable in this case? The answer is titrate treatment, graduated exercises.